Yo, what's up guys, this is Yusuf here, back with another video on the channel, and today we're talking the best and the cheapest PC you can get for PUBG. So this is a new game in the market, you know, called PlayerUnknown's Battleground, or also known as PUBG. And it's a pretty fun to play new modern style battle royale where you kill other players. It's kind of open world, kind of like GTA 5 or just, you know, general GTA games. You kill others, you loot vehicles, you loot money, you build up your empire kind of thing. You get your strategies and you work out to the top of the leaderboard. Now it's a pretty fun to play game as I said, but there are a few downsides. One of them being this can be taxing even on like, you know, really high end hardware, and it's poor optimization right now as it is in really early stages. So the game is not really well optimized and does not work, you know, very well on lower end hardware. So in this video I'm going to be telling you guys the best and the cheapest PC you can get for PUBG, which will get you not only PUBG but other games and also everything you'll do on a Windows 10 PC. So with that being said, let's get into the video. Before starting guys, I appreciate it if you can drop a thumbs up and get subscribed to the channel for more videos like this, and all the parts, all the PCs or everything I talk about in this video will be linked in the description to Amazon US. And yeah, those are affiliate links, so if you want to help the channel out and if you enjoy my stuff, want to see more, buy from those, it helps me out a lot. And with the shameless plug out of the way, let's get into the video. In my opinion, the best way to build a gaming PC for any game, not only PUBG, is to get a pre-built Dell Optiplex or something, or any pre-built PC that has a Core i3 or a Core i5 or even a Core 2 GPU if you're not playing, you know, on really high settings or really demanding games, and then add a really decent or really good graphics card which costs about 150 to 200 bucks, and you're having a pretty solid computer in your hand which can not only play PUBG but any game or do anything that you throw at it. So first up, let's get into the requirements that PUBG asks for if you search for it. Now the first requirement is an Intel Core i3 4340 or an AMD FX 6300. Now those are dual core and hexa core CPUs, they happen to be the minimums. For memory they are asking 6 GB, but according to me 8 GB is the minimum or more will also help. In terms of graphics, you are asking for a GTX 662 GB or AMD Radeon 7852 GB. Now these are all, you know, old graphics cards, so you probably won't find them and you should not be looking for them as well, as these are just minimum requirements. And the next thing you're asking for is a DirectX 11 compatible hardware, which you will be getting in any new graphics card. First thing you want to do is search for Dell Optiplex on Amazon or any, you know, retailer or any online website you want to search and you trust. So you'll get, you know, a list of PCs used, new, and a bunch of PCs ranging from about like $100 to going up to $600 or $800. But we are looking for something that is about $100 to $300 where the value lies. So first choice I have is the Dell Optiplex i5-2400. Now this is a quad-core CPU clocked at 3.1 GHz. You get a 500 GB hard drive, Windows 10 Professional pre-installed. Now this is refurbished, so yeah, keep that in mind. You get a DVD drive. You also get, you know, the essential I/O, USB 2.0, audio jacks, and you also get 8 GB of DDR3. Now this is my recommended spec. You are getting for only $215. Now there is this other PC that I chose, is the Dell Inspiron 79SFF. Now they list high performance premium business desktop computer in the Amazon description, but this is more than enough for what you need for PUBG and stuff. This comes with the Core i3 2100, 3.1 GHz, 8 GB of DDR3, 1 TB of hard drive, DVD drive, and Windows 7 Professional. Again, certified refurbished by Amazon. Looks good, the PC looks decent. This is not gamer or anything fancy, so yeah, you won't be expecting, you know, those cool looking RGB LEDs in here. These are not gaming PCs, these are office computers, but they happen to have really good specs for gaming as well. Now let's get to the graphics card that I recommend you add with these PCs. The first one is this MSI RX 560 Aero ITX version. This comes with 4 GB of GDDR5 overclocked, a 7000 MHz, you know, memory clock. This works on 128-bit memory interface, HDMI, DVI, and DisplayPort, DirectX 12 compatible, and you can play the most demanding games in 1080p, medium to max settings, and still get 60 FPS. Now this is a pretty good graphics card, retailing for about $129. Now if you're into the Nvidia side of things, here's my second recommendation. This is the Gigabyte GeForce GTX 1050 Ti. Again, 4 GB of GDDR5, 128-bit memory interface, and this also comes with DVI, HDMI and DisplayPort, but this is fairly more expensive. And this retails for about $149 to be exact, but you will get the extra performance, you know, for that 20 or so bucks that you pay extra. 1080p at 60fps, again, modern and classic games. And you're looking at, you know, pretty good clock speeds out of the box and no heating issues or anything. Compact in size, pretty good graphics card for about $150. And that's pretty much it. These are the graphics card that I recommend. And with this combo, you are looking at about 1080p medium to max settings in, you know, PUBG 60fps or more. And that kind of wraps it up. Performance will get better day by day as PUBG developers the game to work on lower hardware and also get it optimized for all sorts of graphics cards and, you know, PCs. And that's been it, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then give this video a massive thumbs up. Get subscribed to TechDrops for more videos like this. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.